Thought I'd move to Sydney to get a little piece of the city life they're talking about in the 90s, where everyone I meet don't wanna know my name. They wanna know what I do for a living.
And I've got, well, you know, it's,
well, honey,
if it works, it
don't
works.
Don't record.
Don't
you record it.
Not that.
Anyway,
the songs don't earn me money, fill my pockets with cash every time.
My urban kitchen, and what we're going to try and do here is just to provide some recipes that I cook every day, and I hope you enjoy them as much as I do. So it's lunchtime, and today we're going to cook a Thai beef salad. And what we're going to start off with first of all is the sauce, and that can just marinate for a little while. So I'm just going to cut up some kaffir lime leaves here. So Thai beef salad is a very popular dish because, as you know, at the moment it's very important to have lots of fruit and vegetables. So this is a vegetarian dish with a bit of steak, and it's very nice and refreshing. I'm adding 2 chilies. I quite like it hot, and my friends who are going to help me eat my lunch today are also into chili, so that's good. It's always good to take the seeds out of chilies, and I always find it gets caught in my throat. But they're gonna be hot chilies today. Anyway. Oh my god. Now there is 4 cloves of garlic in here, so once again that's a personal tone, and I just find it easier to peel garlic. Cook's tip of the day, peeling garlic. You can just squash it and then the seed comes off very easily. This is a great salad for lunchtime, I find, with a nice dry white. And I can never go past New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc, and it's the Marlborough. So fantastic bottle of wine. And we might actually end up having to get another one because just put it in the fridge to keep it nice and cold. So we've got in there chili, garlic, and some kaffir lime leaves, which look like this. Very pungent little, very nice. And we're going to put some fish sauce. So a tablespoon or thereabouts of fish sauce. Can I say don't overdo this because it is very strong in flavour. Now the recipe also calls for some lime juice. Some people actually put their limes in the microwave to make the juice come out quicker, but these are beautiful and fresh today. My favourite album at the moment is Sam's Town by The Killers. So a bit of Sam's Town would go down well with this. A bit of white wine, a few friends. Also into this dressing you have to add some palm sugar or brown sugar. Now I happen to have some palm sugar. And once again, just put a couple of tablespoons in, let it sit for about half an hour, and then we'll come back and taste that. But so you can download Sam's Town from urbankitchen.net. You can also download information about the white wine from Marlborough, the Sauvignon Blanc from Marlborough Estate, Stoneleigh. So you can also do that. Very nice. So what I'm going to do now is start making the salad, and what I've got here is some fresh mixed green leaves, lettuce leaves, and also some nice herbs. So I'll just leave that to the side. The other ingredient that I'm adding today, and this is purely optional, are some nice rice noodles, which is also just gives it a little bit more body. So I'm just adding that in today, some nice rice noodles. And really now, it's what you like in a salad. So what I've got is I'm getting some cucumbers, some nice Roma tomatoes, some nice red radishes. I'll also put in some spring onion. And we'll add in some cilantro or coriander, as it's known around Asia, and some nice mint as well. So this is just making up the salad. And all I'm going to do now is chop them all up and into bite-sized pieces. I try and go to fruit and veg markets rather than the chain stores, and I just find that when you buy fruit and veg from these marketplaces, they're a lot fresher and they actually last a couple of weeks in your fridge rather than overnight, which I find sometimes with the big chains I should say. So these are beautiful fresh Roma tomatoes that have been sitting outside the fridge. Cook's tip, outside the fridge. You don't want to put tomatoes in the fridge. So today I've chosen a piece of rump. I'm going to grill the meat to my liking and then I'm going to slice it thinly. So that's all you need to know about the meat, whichever one. I would suggest that you don't use anything other than rump or fillet for this. We're using extra virgin olive oil onto the steak, just rubbing a bit in. This is from Western Australia, so beautiful Western Australian olive oil, just a little bit. Very beautiful. There we go. So you know it's ready to stick the steak on when it's smoking, so I'm just going to actually put it on whole today because we've got a big grill and we just stick it on. Want it medium rare when the blood starts coming up. So you can see there's a little bit of blood coming up through the steak. So what we're going to do now is we're going to just turn it over. I never really gave up on breaking out of this. So this is ready to come off now. The juices are coming out. And what we're going to do is we're just going to slip it onto this tray and let it rest for about 10 minutes. So this is just slicing the beef as thinly as you like it. And as you can see, we do like our beef rare. So now we're just going to get the plates together to serve up the Thai beef salad. And what I like to do is just put some fresh green leaves. Very long rice noodles. Just whatever I've chopped up. So some radish. So that's pretty much as you want to make a salad. That's the way I like to do it. So we're just going to put some slices of beef. And then to finish it off, I've got some of this coriander, cilantro and mint dressing. And the other thing that I prepared earlier on was some fried onions, which is also very nice. So this is just some crisp fried onion. Now, this is the sauce that we made earlier on. And can I tell you, please, just very small amount because this is very rich. You've got the chili, the kaffir lime, and the garlic, and some fish sauce. So we'll just... very, very gently. So as an afterthought, I'm just going to squeeze a little bit of lemon on each plate and also just a dash of olive oil. And that's it. On the corner.